Sometimes we hear from some celebrity to start our program off with a taped soundbite. Not necessary tonight because we have our man in person here. Bart, first off, welcome to the studio. And is it still appropriate to say welcome to town, your first year back in Milwaukee coaching UWM?
I think it's appropriate. Thanks for having me, Tim, Brendan, yeah. Lily. It's been a while. It's been a decade since I've been here. Been back 9 months. It's been an eventful 9 months. And we've got a good Panther team that we're putting on the floor now.
Well, you were an assistant, for folks who don't know, helping out the Marquette program under Buzz Williams. And so a chance to come back to Milwaukee, and it's really been a quick turn here. Everybody's going to want to get in on this conversation. I'll start with first, how difficult is it and how much of a challenge is it to change things? UWM had been in kind of a downward slide. Right now you're riding at the top, right up there with a couple of other teams in the Horizon League.
Yeah, you know, it's a program that deserves to win. And it's a city that deserves to have a winner. And so I thought as we built this that it was important that we get traction right away. Mm-hmm. We've got 13 new guys, so it's been 9 months of a lot of grind. A whole new staff, moved family. It's been a lot, but we've got things going in the right direction. We've got some buzz in the city, I think, and we're fun to watch. We've got good kids, working really hard.
You mentioned the buzz in the city. How important is it? I mean, you were talking about this after Thursday's game a little bit, but how important is it to have your athletes, your school, and then the city buy into your program?
I mean, it's everything. You know, I tell people there's 200,000 Milwaukee graduates, and 74% live in the state, and we've got 24,000 students. So all those folks want something to be proud of. And, you know, Marquette's got a great team, obviously. I'm a Marquette fan to this day, but there's plenty of room for our program and plenty of folks out there that want to cheer.
And Coach, you talked about earlier in the year, I think I saw you on Media Day, you mentioned the chemistry. That's the biggest thing you guys want to work on. A big enough sample size now for this team. How's that chemistry coming along?
I think very well. You know, they're. I kind of laugh at these guys. Like we had great chemistry right off the bat, off the floor. On the floor, they fight like cats and dogs. I mean, they're like brothers already. And sometimes we've talked about late game, they get mad at each other. They want to win. We've got a huge drive to win on this team. And so it's developing quickly. I'm really proud of those guys that I don't have to do anything with them. They spend time together. They're on and off the floor. They're gym rats, so I feel good about where we are.
Youngstown State has now moved up into that top bunch as well. You have them coming up at the end of the week. This is going to be a fun stretch for you guys. Bart, how would you describe yourself as a coach? You had to get all these new guys together. You've seen good results so far. How do you describe yourself doing your job?
Well, I think, I'm kind of a lifer. I was kind of a gym rat growing up. Always wanted to coach. I was a North Carolina fan. I was that kid that at 9 years old wrote a letter to Dean Smith and got a letter back saying, ask your coach. I can't remember what I was asking him. I'm a believer in the process like most coaches. You know, I believe that you wake up, you do the best you can, you hit it the right way, you lay your head on the pillow, you get up and you do it again, and you stack good days. And I think our guys believe in that, and I live it, our staff lives it. I think that's who we are.
Who do you kind of take things from coach-wise? You mentioned writing to Dean Smith when you were a kid. Tim mentioned that you had coached under Buzz Williams here. Who have you looked at and been able to take from to put to your personality and how you work with your guys?
Great question. I had an uncle who actually was just put into the College Soccer Hall of Fame. He was a soccer coach at College of Charleston for 30 years. Never knew anything about soccer, but he's pretty famous, so everybody always asks me about soccer. But he was a kind of a mentor, and I was a head coach young. I was a head coach at 25, so I didn't have a lot of people that I coached under. And then I was 36 when I came to work for Buzz. It's the first time I had been an assistant since becoming a head coach. And really, I would say Buzz was the way you guys know. You've had him on the show. The way Buzz works and the way he organizes, and he was completely different than me. You know, I'm a basketball grinder, and he is, controls the narrative and the social media, and you know, he's mastered all that and relationships with the players. So definitely a huge influence there. But I could go back, high school coaches, and you know, a lot of folks that I look up to.
And, you know, Coach, you come into town, you have a vision for this team, right? Like you mentioned, it was kind of on a downward spiral, but you inspire this team, this new fan base as well. And when you look at kind of what this team has been doing now, is this the start you envisioned, or was it not surprising that you guys would be this good so early to start the year?
I mean, I don't know anything else. I kind of want to win. So, you know, in my mind, this is what it is. You know, I was torn up last night. You know, we lost in overtime. We didn't play very well, and we had won five of our first six league games were on the road, and we had won what, four out of those five. So really set ourselves up in a good place, and we needed to win these home games. And I thought we let one go last night. So our expectations, you know, we're going to go with the process. So I think if you work and you do it right, the results come.
So you're a coach. A lot of coaches say, hey, it's such an emotional game against Northern Kentucky. Then you have to slow start the next game. Kind of see that cycle. But you came back. You guys played well in the second half, made a game of it. And as we saw the standings there, you're riding right at the top. You've talked to these players, a lot of guys from all over the country. Here they are. They show up. You said, come to Milwaukee and play for me. What's the move to Milwaukee been like for you? You're a family guy. There's a lot. You mentioned it, referenced it earlier. There's a lot to get together while you're going to go full speed once you get here to do the job. But there are a lot of things that go along with that.
Yeah, it's you know, if you don't have a happy home, it's going to be a lot harder job. Luckily, I've got great support, and we're here. We're in Shorewood. School's going well. My 9-year-old got to the fourth round of the spelling bee the other day, so that was that was the event of the week, not the games in Milwaukee. So everything's rolling the right way, and we love Milwaukee.
Outstanding. Well, a lot of fans obviously excited to see how it's going so far for the Panthers. We're really happy to have you in. Open door invitation here anytime. Definitely. Thank you. Bart Lundy with us here.